Hello everybody, my name is Manuel. Thank you for listening today. Our group name is called Mr. E. You can get that. Our logo is the letter E, which consists of all of our names written in Arabic. This is Hugo, Austin, CJ, Jesse, Waji, and me. And I'm going to be introducing the artist himself, Waji. First, our motto, as you guys can imagine, is you can't build a house without a team. You, Hugo. I'm going to tell you a little bit about Waji. He is 22 years old, and he's from Libya, North Africa, which is a lot more diverse than America, as you can imagine. Here's a picture of him with his best friend in Libya. And he lived there for 18 years, went to school there, which is a lot different than America, because you have to wear a uniform from first grade to graduating high school. You have to have a white button-up shirt, black pants, tie, vest, and if you didn't wear the uniform, they would actually physically punish you, as well as if you didn't do the homework, just like a ruler, right? And Waji thinks that this is a good learning technique, where a lot of people in America think it's negative. After 18 years, he decided to move to Malta, which is an island in the Mediterranean Sea. He wanted to further his education. It was close to Libya, so he moved there, studied business, learned some English, rode some quads, rode some jet skis. And then after a year there, he decided to move to Chico, where his friend lives now. And in Chico, he got into the rap music. He went to a Tyga concert. He met his girlfriend, which is going to be his fiance, his wife, next week. And his rule was to motivate each other, which is a great rule. Everybody needs motivation. Another thing different about Africa and the U.S. is alcohol consumption. It's completely illegal in Libya, where here it should be completely illegal. So our subject is about alcohol abuse. I'm gonna go to the next slide. Just show up for a second. And I found this article. It's in the American Journal of Medicine, had multiple authors, and I chose this one. It was a study on 240 older senior residents above the age of 60, and they asked them, they said 20% of the parties, of the patients studied had abused or were dependent on alcohol at some time in their lives, and 5% reported abuse or dependence within the last year. Thanks for listening, and here's Waji.
Hello everybody, my name is Waji, and today I will be talking about my friend Austin. He's 19 years old, and he's from a small town called Fort Bragg, and he has been living here for 2 years, and he used to play sports since he was from first grade and all the way up. And as you see here in the picture, his favorite sport is football. And also, I'm gonna be talking about his strengths, which is he's patient and persistent and willing to learn. And I'm gonna also talking about his weakness. His weakness that he's a little bit slacker. And also, he didn't always make school first thing. And his diversity is brave. And he didn't decide what major he's gonna be at. But his goal to be a lineman at BGE company. And I'm gonna be talking about our topic, which is alcohol abuse. And I get this resource from the internet. It shows that 14 countries are illegal drinking alcohol, and one of them was my country, Libya. So it's like no way to be drinking alcohol in Libya because it's completely illegal, and there are like so strict on punishment if they find out you drinking or this you or you selling drink. And I'm in my opinion, I see it as a good thing and it's a bad thing in the same time. It's a good thing, it's because it's like you won't be seeing people drunk and fighting and also being like seeing homeless and everything out in the street. And the bad thing that will affect the people who are like in our age, because they don't have any other activities they can do, only just go to hookah bars, which is worse than the alcohol. And now I'm gonna pass the line to my friend Austin, and thank you.
My name is Austin. I got the pleasure to interview my friend Jesus. He was born here in Chico, but he grew up and was raised in Orlan. He's diverse in our group because he's patient and he pays attention to detail very well. He pays attention to detail well because he works at Chico Nissan as a detailer, so that helps him like take his time and like make sure everything's perfect and pay attention to detail, which I think is a great attribute for this group. He keeps us all like paying attention and not slacking at all. And his education goal is to obtain his AA in criminal justice and move up to a CSU, and then his life goal is to be a game warden. He played football since he was 7. He also played soccer, basketball, and track. I'm going to talk about some of his strengths and weaknesses. Now, his strengths are he's trustworthy, he's patient, honest, and respectful. And his weaknesses are he procrastinates, like a lot of us do. He's shy, and he's stubborn. Now I'm going to talk about our topic, alcohol abuse, which I think is a good one for this area, because we all know Chico is a pretty big party town, and I bet you a lot of this happens around here. Okay, so the source I got was last updated on September 17th, 2017. The author is the U.S. National Library of Medicine, and the quote I pulled was, "For most adults, moderate alcohol consumption is probably not harmful. However, 18 million adults have an alcohol disorder." And like I said, I think that is a good one for around this area because it's pretty controversial. And you have people saying that it's not bad, and you have people saying it's good or bad. Now I'm going to pass it on to my friend Jesus, who got the pleasure to interview CJ.
Hi, my name is Jesus. I got the pleasure to interview Celestino. He's 19 years old. He was born in Rabluff and raised in Corning. Celestino is working towards getting a bachelor's in nursing. He also wants to transfer to Chico State to get into the nursing program. Celestino likes to play video games, work on his car, go camping and hiking on his free time. He also played tennis for his high school, and also he played the saxophone for the high school band. Some of his strengths are he's a fast learner, has good people skills, he's understanding, good listener. And some of his weaknesses are gets frustrated, has really high expectations, and procrastinates. One rule that he put towards this group was break a rule, buy a pizza. Now we'll be talking about our next project on alcohol abuse. I found this website by Lauren Kelly. It was last updated on Wednesday, August 9th. I got a quote from this website. It said, high risk drinking was defined as four or more drinks on any day for women, five or more drinks for men, and how many times people exceed those standards weekly in a year. Now I'll be passing it to Celestino. He'll be talking about his interviewee, Hugo.
Hi, I'm Celestino, or CJ, and I got the pleasure of interviewing Hugo. He's a first generation stateside born, meaning he's the first generation that was born in America. He's a Chico native, which is kind of cool because not many people are necessarily from another country and then just come to Chico, except for, of course, Waji. His future goal was to become a police officer or a deputy sheriff, which I thought was kind of cool because as a child, one of his favorite things to do was play cops and robbers. And let me tell you, I would not want to be the cop chasing him. Once he turned 18, he enlisted in the Army National Guard, but he's never been deployed yet. And when he turned 21, he got a job bouncing at clubs, or at bars. He started weightlifting his junior year of high school, but didn't really get serious until he graduated, which the results are pretty, paying off pretty well. He enjoys going to sporting events with his family, and has always wanted to travel, but he's never really had the time to. He's diverse to this group because he's a wild card. You never really know what he's going to say. For instance, we all remember the "you can't build a group without a house," which became our logo, well, our motto. His rule was, you gotta pull your own weight, which he's pretty used to doing that. Now I'm going to be talking about our next project, which is alcohol abuse. And I chose to talk about alcohol abuse in college students. I found a quote that really stood out to me, written in 2015 by MJ Ikes. He wrote, "It is estimated that 30% of college students meet the criteria for alcohol abuse, which is a really big number. And it's really relevant to all of us because we live in a party town where this number is probably amplified." And now I'm going to pass it off to Hugo so he can finish us up.
So long, guys. My name's Hugo. Got the pleasure of meeting you, interviewing Manuel Lopes, not Lopez. Descends from Portugal. Born in Christine, California. Moved to Chico last March. Once he came into town, he actually hopped on Craigslist looking for a band to put drums in called the Sunny Acres. Ad said, looking for a drummer cooler than the bottom of a ice chest. The bottom left picture actually shows him at a house party performing about a year ago. I think now we know about 3 months ago, CJ himself decided to move in that same house. Plans on getting a major in business and entrepreneurship. And with that, he's gonna try to move up in a company called Dwizzy that he works for. Currently, he's doing logistics with them. They make sunglasses and watches. You guys should just check him out one time. He also likes to play music, hang out with his dog Otis. He's 6 years old and is just very dear to him. His one rule was to share ideas, promote it, sell it, and own it. What really makes Manuel diverse is that he's just really on top of it and he's really just, you know, has bigger plans than what most people do, I guess you could say. Next, I'm going to be talking about our next project, which is alcohol abuse in the military. In a recent report by the Institute of Medicine, called Drugs and Alcohol, said that it is a public crisis. In a recent study that the Institute did in the Army, that they handed out a survey about December, got back to it a month later, reported that 43% of active duty military admit to binge drinking, and also 67% of those people that admitted to drinking were between the ages of 17 to 25. I just want to sum up our group real quick. We got Waji, Manuel, Austin, Jesse, and CJ and myself. We're all a pretty cohesive group. We all get together really well. We all come from really diverse backgrounds. We're all some type of foreign besides Austin over here from Fort Bragg. You know, we all get along really well. We're pretty concrete learners. We all learn hands-on. And that's just really how we all get together and get along.